One obvious case is when the population of interest is small, and we are able to get information from each element of the population. In these cases, a census is possible, and it would be better, and probably not much more difficult or expensive, than a representative sample. In general, a representative sample would be more desirable than a non-representative sample when the objective is to make inferences about the population. However, in some cases, it is not possible to go through the process of getting a representative sample, and we need to use non-representative samples. For example, when the population of interest cannot be properly identified or found. This may happen when there is an intrinsic interest from the people in the study population to not be found. For example, when they want to avoid negative consequences, such as imprisonment or deportation, or when the subject of interest is legally or morally considered undesirable. In these cases, we may need to use ways to get to elements of the population of interest that are based on networks of contacts, using methods like snowball sampling or respondent-driven sampling, which attempts to improve the results from snowball sampling using a mathematical model that weights the sample to compensate for the fact that it is non-representative. Some common methods that yield non-representative samples are accessibility sampling and quota sampling. But these would require strong justification before using them. Basically, this has to do with the fact that they may make life easier during the field operations, but the issues of bias and the impossibility to calculate margins of error are serious drawbacks.